thought we were all supposed to have a fresh start here.
Yeah.
I can't change the past.
Sins
well,
of a...
Well, you can't change people's memories either.
Previous time. When we're...
Look,
well, some
I'm
of us were savages.
It's fair, but it's real. People are scared of you.
And that's why I'm the goddamn sheriff.
Look at your hands.
My hands? You should see the other guy.
Who'd you get in a fight with? A fable, right? I'm sure you're not going around punching Mondays.
I did my job.
I was doing my job, believe it or not.
Although,
your job is to beat the shit out of fables.
When they need
sometimes
it.
Sometimes I take them to the farm.
And sometimes
fuck
they stay there.
You.
Wow, Colin. I'm happy that we have this such friendly relationship.
Easy, you try keeping a bunch of fables from killing each other. How do you think this all works?
Or just killing me.
I don't know. How?
By being big and being bad.
By being big and being bad. Don't say that shit in front of people. It's embarrassing.
Oh, well. It sounded pretty cool coming out of my head.
In trouble. I'm sure you were shitty to everyone you came across tonight.
No.
Everyone.
Amazingly
name
enough.
One.
I don't know her name, actually. It was... And Beauty. I ain't gonna tell you about Beauty.
I don't actually know her name.
Awesome. Great example.
I'm not trying to justify my position to you, pig.
Life is easier with friends, Bigby.
Is it?
And we live a long fucking time.
I think life is more complicated.
I know you like this whole lone wolf thing you got going for yourself. But I've seen the way you look at Snow, okay? You're not fooling me.
Will you shut up?
Snow is out of my league.
Maybe if my throat wasn't so parched, I wouldn't have to keep talking.
Maybe because you're talking so fucking much, your throat is parched.
Colin, enough already. I haven't slept in 2 days. I went out a second story window.
I fucked up Toad's car really good.
2 seconds of shut-eye before I... Look, if I give you this, will you let me sleep?
Where the hell is my bed?
Probably.
Is there another room in here? Yeah, Colin, I'll give you a drink. I don't need to be a complete and total asshole. Here you go. Now stop busting my balls for a half a second. Get the fuck out of my apartment and go back to the farm. Or get goddamn glamour on yourself, for God's sakes. The hell am I the bad guy? I'm trying to maintain or keep the law straight. Sure, people aren't gonna like me because they don't like someone fucking bearing down on them with rules, but somebody has to do the dirty work. I could probably do it in a lot more pleasant and friendly way, but fuck you. It's a little bit easier this way. A lot of bit easier. Why am I adjusting my tie?
Bigby!
Hello?
Oh, come with me.
Snow White! How are you doing? Funny, I was just talking about you.
Snow.
How long have I had a chance to sleep?
Snow!
What?
What's going on?
Sorry, I'm... What is it?
What happened?
I just can't get into it this second. We need to hurry to...
I think you'll have a chance. There's always
well,
a chance.
Good morning. Or evening.
Yeah.
So I've gotten no sleep at all. Hey, redhead. Who the fuck is that guy?
These walls are paper thin.
Yeah, it's a bit of a shithole around here.
We need to be careful. We'll talk outside.
Okay, that's pretty much all you really need to say. Just preface it with, can't talk here. You know, let's get somewhere where we can talk. Very important, though. Can't stress that enough. Ooh, to pop in achievements like crazy. I love it. What do we have? Is that the... No, that's not Gilby. The security guy. What is this? What is going on here? Security jacket. Left on the front stoop. Step of the, building. Alright. Hey, did I tell you about this girl I ran into earlier this evening? She was out with the woodsman. Had to kick the shit out of him. Seemed like a really Oh, Jesus Christ! Well, that's her. I guess that $58 was not enough.
Is... She's not a Mundy, right?
I believe she was a fable.
Who was she? I thought I knew everyone in Fabletown. She looks familiar.
She's just a girl.
Can't replace her, though.
Just a girl. We didn't have a whole lot of time to chat.
I'm surprised that Snow didn't go further into that. You've seen her earlier? Talked to her?
He attacked her, I stepped in. And he threatened to kill us both.
We kicked the shit out of him pretty good.
I don't think anything yet. Just give me a second.
Let's investigate the head.
Terrible. It took me a second to realize what I was even looking at.
Who found her?
Who found her?
I did.
Oh, awesome.
She was just like this. I didn't touch her. I grabbed Grimble's jacket to cover her with. Then...
Oh, so you're the one that put the jacket there.
No one else was with you?
No.
Alright.
Did one of us do this?
There hasn't been a murder in Fabletown in a long time.
All the more reason we shouldn't start a panic before we know what's going on.
Well, the fact that they left it as pretty much a calling card on the front stoop of our building.
Have a look around.
A building full of fables.
People will be coming through here.
Kind of leads to the suspicion that, yeah, this is intentional. That they murdered this girl and left her head on, I guess you can fucking kill a fable.
Strange cut. What did this to her?
Jesus. What could do something like that?
Either something very sharp or something with magic attached to it.
Examine the head.
She was placed here with some care.
What do you mean?
It wasn't tossed.
You can see that someone didn't just toss her here. She was deliberately placed for us to find.
Mm-hmm.
What kind of monster would do this?
Somebody who'd cut off a fucking young girl's head. Something in her mouth.
What is?
Some evidence. Well, of course, evidence. Everything along here is that. Oh, that's her ribbon.
Her ribbon?
With a ring attached to it.
Some kind of symbol here.
Huh.
Was she wearing that ring?
I don't recognize it.
I don't even remember.
Neither do I.
Well, this is a fucking great cap off to the end of the evening for me. Oh, there's some blood over here. Let's see if I can... Where's the rest of the body?
I'm sorry. This is just so surreal.
Yeah, it's pretty fucked up, actually. And since it's all fable business, I guess we have to...
What do you want to do next?
Investigate it ourselves. We need to investigate.
We still have some time. I should keep investigating the area.
See what evidence can be found around here. We got the ring... Oh, can I take a look at the matchbook, or... Cool. Huh.
Hey, Snow. You alright?
Yes. Thanks. But you should hurry. We don't have much time left. We should head back inside soon.
Yeah, we will head back inside as soon as I'm done, you know, taking a look around the area, seeing if there's any other clues or leads around here to, show us who or why this happened. God damn. Fucking. There's a head. Within, like, the first hour of the game, it's like, okay, well, someone's been decapitated. Figure it out. Big B. Hey, Sheriff. There's the blood. Observe that. Quite a bit of improvements on the blood textures that they've done as well.
Drops of blood. Say it's been here an hour, maybe.
So I managed to get an hour's worth of sleep. Hooray. What do we have here? Just a piece of garbage?
Fabric. Looks like jeans. Doesn't tell me much.
Nope. Amazingly enough, way too many people still wear jeans nowadays. Way too uncomfortable and restrictive. Why? I don't know. Well, there's no body. That's good. Same piece of Chinese food and Huff Puff cigar or cigarettes.
More blood. Someone might have hopped the fence, got caught, and left the trail I found earlier.
So whoever left the head has a really fucked up wound on them.
Still wet.
That's still wet,
sharp
but the
enough.
Blood from probably her leaking head has already congealed on the ground. Interesting. So, found that piece of fabric as well. I don't know if I can look at that stuff at another time, or... Oh, I guess I can share that with you. Oh, I'm investigating her pants.
What are you doing?
I'm...
Better to be thorough.
Try not to get slapped.
Sure, just... Hurry up. We don't have much time.
Wow. We should...
We should...
Probably cover that up.
Move her. Before anyone shows up. We'll find out more at the business office. She'll be in the books. I'm sure of it. Bigby, do you have any idea what's going on?
Well, somebody brought her here.
Why her?
Definitely. That's one thing I learned with this game. It's you have to wait a little bit longer before answering. Because they keep talking.
From the outside.
That makes sense. There's no signs of a struggle. But how do you know?
Found some blood on the fence. Blood trail, blood on the fence, blood trail, blood on the fence. Pretty much the same thing.
Found blood on the fence back there. Someone hopped over.
Okay, good. That's solid. So, someone from the outside. Well, at least they didn't come from inside the woodlands.
It's great that Snow agrees with my theory. It's a pretty solid theory.
I'm gonna have to tell Crane about this.
Ichabod Crane?
As long as King Cole is gone, he's acting mayor.
Who the fuck is King Cole?
And he's going to find out anyway, so we may as well get out in front of it. It'll just be worse if he finds out we held it from him. I know you don't like him, but he's our boss.
Do what you need to do.
Part of the job.
I guess it's useless to drag it out.
That's how I feel too. I'm sure he won't be happy, but it's just part of the process. Hopefully he can be rational about it.
Ichabod Crane?
My breath.
Never really known to be rational.
I just don't want him interfering.
There was that whole incident with him and the Headless Horseman way back when. He's been kind of a bag of nerves ever since.
Right, we need to figure out who this girl was so we can find whoever did this. Take this back to Dr. Swinehart. He can take a look at it. I'll meet you at the business office.
Okay. I'll head it off at the pass. Oh, yeah! Okay, not good. Too soon. Too soon. Sorry. Bit of a dick move there. Making light of the decapitated girl. Be nice to figure out who the hell it is. What the fuck is this bag of yokels? Tiny Tim?
Blind?
No, I
you
just...
don't see there's a line?
Don't give a fuck.
I've been standing here a half hour already. You get to just walk in? Must be nice being the sheriff. Do whatever the fuck you like.
I'm cutting the line,
I'm
bitch.
Cuts? Is that supposed to be funny?
I think it's pretty fucking funny.
You see anyone here laughing? Sheriff.
I'm laughing pretty hard on the inside.
Fucker.
I can see that we're going to be just swell friends.
Yes, I see. I... Because you are the one bringing this to me, Miss Snow. The one who so simply stumbled upon this catastrophe on our very doorstep. The last thing I need with Mayor Cole away is a hysteria. Do you understand me?
Oh, Ichabod.
Yes,
fucking flying off the handle again.
Miss Snow.
You asked me a question.
Don't change the subject. You are to blame for this unpleasantness, Miss Snow.
I brought you this news as soon as I could.
You are trusted to keep things running smoothly around here. This is a disaster. Who else is to blame if not you?
You are
back
a
off,
dickhead.
It's not her fault.
I don't need your help, Bigby.
Instead of trying to assign blame, maybe we should figure out how to catch the fucker who did this.
Oh, says the man who is most to blame for this catastrophe.
Really?
How convenient.
How do you come
Sheriff,
about that assumption?
You are the one charged with protecting the citizens of Fabletown. Your failure to do so cost someone their life and the safety of the entire community.
I'm just one man.
Tell me you've been
I took
doing
a
something.
Goddamn nap, and
suspect.
There's a fucking head on the doorstep.
Anything at all.
And
any
yet,
shred of evidence you two know what the hell you're doing.
Right
now, I have half a mind to fire the both of you.
I imagine it was a her pimp. I can't throw much at fucking...
Was she a...
Yeah.
Oh, that calmed you down,
she
didn't it, dickhead?
About a money situation.
Can't really throw blame on the woodsman.
This is just wonderful. Not only is a fable killed...
He's drunk and stupid and passionate, but...
You two need to get a handle on this situation quickly and quietly. The last thing
what the
we
fuck
need
are
is
you gonna do?
Town knowing there's a killer amongst us. Snow.
Yes?
That's Ms. Snow.
Call Vivian right this minute and let her know I'm coming in early for my massage.
I will.
What, is she your fucking secretary now?
Where is the bottle of wine you were to purchase?
Wow, speaking of changing the subject.
Forget it. Can't do anything right.
Wow.
Do
I think I'm gonna fucking hit you.
We'll find someone who can.
You know what?
Stop. We'll get on it right away, sir.
Yeah, fuck you is my response to you. The hell of that.
You would have just pissed him off more.
Good. That would give me a reason to kick the shit out of him.
Well, that could have gone better. Well, maybe we should have dragged it out.
For what it's worth, I still think it was better to tell him.
Yeah, maybe.
He was going to fucking flip
Crane
off anyways.
Doesn't like people smoking and...
There's a lot of things that Crane doesn't
Never
like.
Mind. Smoke away.
Yeah, that's it.
What an asshole.
Crane is an asshole.
That was about an 8 on the asshole scale. Asshole scale? Well, that doesn't sound right.
When you're talking about Crane, it sure does.
Is he gone?
What the fuck are you? Well, there's the wine that he was curious about. It appears everyone's getting drunk off their ass tonight.
Buffkin?
Hello.
The fuck name is that?
Drinking? This early? Where did you get that?
It was by Mr. Ichabod's desk.
Then don't you think it probably belongs to him?
Fuck him. I mean...
Maybe.
Flying monkey, so I guess Wizard of Oz fits into the whole Fables universe here.
How are you today, Mr. Bigby?
Integrating, like, the... I'm not great, Buffkin.
It hasn't been a great morning, Buffkin.
Sorry.
Eh, not your fault. Thanks for asking, though.
Is it morning now? Did I actually get a couple hours of sleep?
Which books?
The ones with all the fables in it.
Not sure that was any more specific.
The Grimm Brothers, that's what I was talking about there. I guess...
Be back in a few minutes.
You know, taking into consideration the fables of Snow White, Beauty and the Beast, and all that. I think Beauty and the Beast is part of the Grimm Brothers' fables, but I didn't know that, like, Wizard of Oz fell into that.
In the meantime, poke around. Maybe the mirror can help.
So that's,
I really have to get this appointment squared away, but let me know if you need anything.
Yeah, that's the same... Wow, even Aladdin. Jesus. Pretty much any Disney property. Not saying that Disney owns every legend or fable property, but any Disney property you can think of.
Hey, magic mirror.
This, I guess, encompasses that.
You know the rule.
I don't have time for this shit.
Your impatience is callow. You're needlessly cruel, but have some respect for our history rules.
Don't you have to rhyme every time?
Mirror, mirror. If you're able, tell me all about this fable.
See? Was that so hard?
Don't be a dickhead about it.
2 seconds away from kicking a hole in you.
There's no need for that. Fine.
There's no need for...
Of which fable do you wish to know?
I have no fucking clue. Tell me about Buffkin action. Actually, just tell me about this piece of shit.
Hey, put down the bottle and get to work.
Still looking?
No, you're not. You're getting fucking plastered, ass. Tell me about the woodsman. What the fuck is he doing right now?
Where is he?
He's way too drunk right now.
The woodsman stumbles down a street.
No shit. Which street?
I'm sorry, Bigby. I can only show you what can be seen.
So you showed me fucking nothing.
Show me Snow White.
Wow, that happy intent on his face.
Request. She's in this very room.
I'm just gonna go through all of the options.
Not yet, anyway.
Well, until you do, I can't help you.
Always a pleasure, Magic Mirror.
Very well. Please return should you wish to ask about someone else or someone new.
Sure. As soon as I discover whatever the hell the girl's name was. Yeah, Buffkin's bringing what appears to be the necessary books to perhaps discover that. Oh, no, Buffkin just shit the bed like every other thing he's attempted to do in his life.
Okay.
Stupid flying monkey. This room is pretty fucking metal right now. Giant sword in the background. It's like Roman Pantheon shit going on in the background. Did I just drop a major fucking shit on Ichabod Crane's desk? Be like, hey, Crane, this is what I think about you.
Pretty much just lamps.
So Robin Williams got away. Not too soon on that. He's been dead for years, people. Stay calm.
Worth a try.
Mm-hmm. Fucking right, it's worth a try. See a magic lantern? Damn right, so I'm gonna try to polish that up. Alright, the good old exterior collisions. Tarot deck? What the hell do we got going on here?
Jack brought him back from Appalachia. Who knows where they were before then.
Jack and the Beanstalk? Jack?
To get him.
Yeah, I guess climbing beanstalks and then wanting to climb the Appalachian Mountains seems appropriate.
I guess it comes in all forms.
It's very poignant of a young girl with a wolf. Let's see, is this the tower? Oh, that looks like snow. What the fuck? Interesting. Very weird. I don't know my tarot card, so... Oh, that's...
Just what the fuck is this supposed to mean?
Yeah, that looks a lot like me in that photo. I guess I'm gonna hold on to that tarot card then. Sure, why the fuck not? Or it's... Look at that giant gauntlet over there. Yes. Book of Fables. Not quite done checking out the environment here. Wow, you sit in a giant area where your desk is pretty much just 5 feet away from Ichabod Crane's desk. Fantastic. Okay, let's take a look at the Book of Fables first. Sure, why not? That's Cinderella. Yeah, got a tree and some shit going on here. Approximate, well. Alright. Hey, the woodsman is fucking axe. Robin Hood, no, that is not English. Seems like Spanish, honestly. Anise Pelham. Girl wearing a donkey suit. Elvish
what?
Text. Oh, yeah.
I can't read any of this shit.
I can help.
Can you, Bufkin?
Yeah, thanks.
We look out for each other.
Do we?
I'll never do it. What's it say about that?
It says Bricklebit in an older elvish hand.
What's Bricklebit?
A magic word.
What's it do?
Makes animals shit gold.
Okay. Would it work on you? Are you animal enough? Interesting. Oh, bumper, not trigger. That's a Jabberwocky. I fucking know a Jabberwocky if I've seen one in the world. What symbol is
that?
It reads, Mark of the House of the Frog Prince.
Frog Prince.
Who I'm looking for.
This ring definitely looks quite similar to the one that I found of that girl's. Honestly, I can't remember who the hell that girl is. Oh, got a Celtic symbol here.
Yes, from the Axe of the Woodsman, a druid blessing.
Druids,
actually.
Celtic,
someone
whatever.
Bless that thing.
I only translate.
Don't shoot the goddamn messenger. Sylvanus Securus. Ooh, what do we have here?
Translate.
An exquisite design from the good china of Toad Hall.
A lot of toad shit.
He probably wrote this in himself.
Okay. Yeah, there's... Cinderella, night and day, it's Cinderella. Hey, that ring looks very familiar.
Where's this symbol from? Which family or story?
That's an odd one. Family name? Alerlairau?
Alerlairau.
Alerlairau. It's every kind of fur in German.
Donkey skin.
Yes. What does it say?
Donkey skin girl, also known as donkey skin, also known as ass skin.
Calm down, Bufkin.
Go by the name Faith. Poetic.
Bufkin,
Faith.
We don't need the commentary.
The story of donkey skin. There was once a great king with a beautiful queen. The queen grew ill and had her husband promise to only marry the most beautiful girl in the kingdom. After a long search, it became clear that the only woman in the land that could match her beauty was...
Donkey skin?
His daughter, Faith.
Oh, that's fucking creepy and weird, but typical of these stories.
She had a magic cloak made from the skin of her father's prized donkey that would hide her beauty so she could escape his kingdom. Eventually, she married a prince who could see past the magic cloak and knew her true beauty. And they lived happily ever after.
Hmm. So a man's wife died, and he promised to only marry someone just as beautiful, and it turned out to be his goddamn daughter.
Yes. Please.
And of course, the king's like, I'm all in on that! Fucking weirdo. Donkey skin, also known as Faith. Yeah, that was her name.
What's her husband's name?
Lawrence. Prince Lawrence.
Prince Lawrence.
We got what we came for.
Yeah.
Her name's Faith. She was married to Prince Lawrence. I mean, that's more than...
Her name was Faith.
I never got a chance to look at that other book. Please give me that opportunity. Do not rob me of that.
To the husband.
You think he did it?
He seems like a... Well, we have to let him know at least. Now, the husband's always the first suspect.
This sort of thing, it's usually the person who knew them best.
Yep.
Or it's someone completely random.
Both are very valid options. But we can't rule those out. Yes, thank you for not completely allowing me to miss any more lore. Because, goddamn, there's some good lore around here. Anything about these arrows? No. Well, now that I learned more about Donkey Skin, will you give me any more information about her? Because this appears to be Faith. And the skin of her father's prized donkey. No, I guess that was it for information out of that book. Well, let's take a look at this book of fables.
Any information on fables in our community will be somewhere in these books. We already know her name, but feel free to have a look if you like.
Yeah, let's get a little bit of background there. Hey, look at me back in my good old days.
Me.
Wow.
I'm pretty sure that's supposed to be me.
And your creepy bunch of asshole dwarf friends.
Dwarves. Less said about that, the better.
They look shady as fuck. Hey, woodsman. You actually look
the
like
woodsman?
A hero. Little Red.
I wonder what the story was.
Beauty.
Beauty. In happier days.
Why is she so unhappy now? Beasts?
Her man. Beast.
Funny.
Hey, Colin.
Colin and his brothers.
Oh yeah, I guess Colin is part of the three little pigs, isn't he? Why not, hey? This is fucking quite beautifully animated. Okay, so that's Faith right there, and that's Faith's father.
That's her, all right. Long time ago.
Fucking Ichabod.
Ichabod.
Chicken shit.
Scared shitless.
What's that?
Your boss. Finest moment.
Yeah, that's what I'd stand by.
Hard to understand how he ended up running this place.
Well, he doesn't have to wear a glamour because he was always a man. Well, what you'd call a man. He was always a humanoid figure.
Badger around for a while.
He likes his privacy, I think.
Badger.
Wish Toad would like his a bit more.
And not a shit on Toad. That was it. That is all you had to say about Toad? Okay, cool. Good story, Big B. Thought he'd be a little bit more in depth about Toad. Like, man, I fucked up a lot of Toad's things. You know, I think that apartment building he runs right now, and it's not great. Hey, tell me about this tarot card.
You know
actually,
what this means?
I've never asked about that before.
Tarot is a backwards art. I wouldn't put too much stock in its wisdom, Big B.
It's not what I asked.
Not
Mirror.
So helpful.
Prevision's muddy. I'm as clear as a window.
No, you are as obtuse and backwards as a window could be, honestly. That is a weird
mirror,
reflection.
Mirror, blah blah able, blah 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 about this fable.
Of which fable do you wish to know?
Can you tell me anything about Faith?